take a look at what this local Fox affiliate did with Donald Trump's speech to the nation earlier this week. Now, the footage appears to be doctored, showing Donald Trump sticking out his tongue between sentences, which he didn't do in the original video. Now, the news director of Q13 admitted this was problematic.
This does not meet our editorial standards, and we regret if it is seen as portraying the president in a negative light.
Even before the speech, we heard a number of voices calling for it not to be aired.
Like they've done with other presidents in other times, the networks should refuse to turn over the airwaves to Donald Trump tonight for what they know objectively to be a steady stream of lies.
First of all, just because Trump wants to address the nation doesn't mean networks should air it. Otherwise, they're just passing on his lies unfiltered.
And some of the fact-checking also got interesting. For example, Donald Trump's claim that 90% of the heroin in the United States comes from over the border was widely criticized because most of that comes through legal ports of entry, and a wall wouldn't really do much to change that. However, one claim that Donald Trump made about two-thirds of women who are smuggled across the border being raped in the process turned out to be true. So, conveniently, CBS then removed it from their fact check. And U.S. mainstream media continues to show this reel of footage of U.S. Border Patrol agents dumping out and kicking over water that was left for migrants in the hot desert areas.
There's video of Border Patrol agents dumping water on the ground, water that was meant to be left for migrants. This is from the Tucson-based aid group.
Now, the video is supposed to be an example of cruelty and heartlessness by immigration enforcers, and it certainly is. However, the video first surfaced in 2013, and it was filmed back in 2011. These were Obama's guys. They have nothing to do with Trump's Border Patrol. And it's worth noting that Obama actually deported more immigrants than any other president in U.S. history. Washington, D.C. is in a state of paralysis. The government is shut down. Donald Trump is demanding funding for his border wall, and the Democrats are adamant that they will not give it to him. It seems like the partisanship and division that is so widespread in Washington, D.C. has now found its way onto Americans' airwaves. Caleb Maupin, RT, New York.